हेलो गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल। इट्स मी अनिल एंड वी आर इन द सीरीज ऑफ ऑनलाइन जॉब पोर्टल यूजिंग ASP.NET। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो दैट इज पार्ट नंबर 10, वी हैव सीन हाउ अ यूजर कैन चेक द हाउ अ यूजर कैन चेक द जॉब डिटेल्स एंड हाउ दे कैन अप्लाई फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर जॉब। ओके, so now in today's video, that is part number 11, we are going to see how can an admin check the applied job by the user and they can download their resume which is in doc file or in PDF file. Okay, and they can also check the for which job they have applied by the user. Okay, so we'll see in this video. Okay, so let's close this browser. It's an admin panels page. Okay, so that's why we need to create a page inside this admin folder. So right click on it, add new item. Web form with master page. Here we'll give page name. I'm giving here view resume. Now select your master page that is present here inside this admin folder. Okay. Now let's design this page, which is very similar to the job list in the admin panel here. This one, job list design page. So we'll copy whole code from here. Okay, and paste here in our new page view resume. So here we need to change the page title, that is view job, sorry, view resume. Or can say download resume. Save it. Now we want grid view to display the applied jobs by the user. Okay, in grid view, like we want this page size, page index change we want, but we don't have this event, so we'll create it. Just press control spacebar, so it will give option here to create a new event. Enter. So it will create an event in the code behind page. Can see in view resume, can see the event has been generated here. And after that, data key names, so we need to change here the data we are going to display here from the table. Let's open our database here. So this is a table, applied jobs. Let's open it. Okay, so this is a primary key column, so we need this ID. So just copy it and paste it here. Instead of job ID, we need to paste that applied job ID. Okay, we want this on row deleting event, so let's create an event for that. Enter. So you don't want this on row data, on row command event. We'll remove that, save it. Okay, we have got the event created here. Now for the column, we want the first one serial number, we want job total also. Okay, we'll use that. Just before that, we need one more column. That is the company name. Then job title, and then username, then user email, then mobile number, I think mobile is there. We don't want this one, so we're going to remove till here we're going to remove. Now here instead of added, we're going to take here resume, and we don't want the link button here, so we'll remove that. We'll take here one hyperlink from the toolbox, hyperlink, double click on it or just drag and drop. Now here let's remove this hyperlink text from here. So here we'll take a I tag, and after the I tag we'll take text as download, because we are going to provide one column for downloading the resume of a user. Okay, and here inside this I tag, first of all we'll take one class inside the I tag, that is font awesome a dot hyphen download. Okay, after that here, okay, that's it here. Save it. We'll remove this width from here. And for the delete column, I think code will be the same. Okay, no need to change here. Okay, so we have done with the design page. Now let's go to the code behind page. View code. So it will take us to the code behind page of view resume. Now we'll copy the code from job list.axps.cs page. Open that. We'll copy this first one. We'll paste here just before the page load event. Let's import the namespace. Now in page load event, we'll take this one, paste, we'll copy this one function, and we'll modify accordingly here. Now we'll change here show job to show applied job. Here we'll show the applied job by the user, the job has which has been applied by the user. So this is a function name. So we'll copy here and paste it here. Save it. Now I need to change your query. Okay. We want this the row number and the serial, which is which will going to display in the column serial number. Then okay, we'll change here code. Let's create in SQL Server page. Okay, and just copying this part. Okay, and let's open our SQL Server and take your new query. I'm pasting the copied one here. Now let's complete this query. From which table we are going to display here? From the applied job table, right? So we'll take here the table applied jobs. Okay, and here we'll can see here the column job ID and user ID. So it's like T as a foreign key, which is coming from the job table, and same as for the user ID also, which is coming from the user table. So both are here, both the columns are with foreign key here, and the job ID is the primary key. So based on that, we'll want to get data from both the tables, that is from the user table also, from the job table also. So we need to do here in a join. Okay, so we need to give your like ls name, ls of this table name. So for this applied job aj, I am taking. Okay, then we'll take here inner join. For which table? We'll take here first the user table. Okay, but we need to take inside this square bracket. Okay, then we'll give the alias here u, and we'll need to pass the condition on which column ID they are going to match. Okay, so for we need to pass that also u dot user ID or aj, or can say aj dot user ID is equal to u dot user ID. Now again we need to take inner join for the job table thing jobs here. We'll take ls as j on aj dot job ID dot job ID is equals to j dot job ID. Okay, now we need to take the column, which column we need to display here, comma aj dot applied job ID comma j dot company name comma aj dot job ID comma j dot title, that is job title, then u dot mobile, and u dot name comma u dot email comma u dot resume okay. So let's copy this query from here and paste here. save it. So it will get data from our tables, and we'll going to fill it in data table object, and then it will going to fill or display in grid view. Okay, now we want this also page index changing, so it's already there in job details, sorry, job list. This one copy paste, then it call the function, so applied job. Yeah, we have this row deleting also here, so we'll copy from here, copy and paste inside this row deleting event. Okay, let's change this function because we have so applied job, and we'll take here one final block after the cache block, and we'll close your connection on dot close, so we can remove from here as well as from here, so save it, and can do same for this job list also. Okay, let's take here this final block, copy, and paste. So we'll remove this one as well as from this one, save it. Okay, now let's change here for this as per our this page requirement, like at previous the job list it's taking a job ID, now we'll take here applied job ID, so we'll make it applied job ID. Okay, so let's copy this, paste it here, and here we need to provide applied job, applied job from table applied jobs, copy it, paste here, and need to pass the applied job ID also, copy, paste here. Okay, so it will going to delete the record from the job applied jobs with the help of applied job ID. Okay, so that ID will going to get from this data key name that is inside our design page. We resume here in design page, will get from here, that is data key names. Okay, that is our the table's primary key column. Okay, applied job ID. Now after that, so it will going to like display success message and like error message, so let's change your message, that is from job deleted successful to resume deleted successful, cannot delete this record. Okay, that's fine. Anything, yeah, rest of this code is same. Okay, let's save it and run in browser. Let's log in as an admin. Click on view resume. So here we get our the page that we have created here, title view resume, then the grid view in which we are displaying the serial number, column name, sorry, company name, the data you can see, the user who has applied for a job will display here. Okay, the applied jobs, the job title. Okay, then the username, who, which user has applied the job, and the email also. Okay, then you can see here this this user, the first user, that is the same for the second and third, that means the first user has applied 3 job and the second one single job has applied. Okay, so their contact number, and so this is the details of the user, like admin can get from here, like their name, email and contact number, and rest of the details they can find inside the resume. Okay. Okay. We have forgot here one thing in the design part for resume column. Like we need to download. When we click on here, it should download the resume. Okay. So let's go to the design page of view resume page. Thing here. Here we need to take navigate URL. Let's take single quote. Single quotes. Okay. Now here let's take open angular bracket. Percentage. Okay. Now hash space data binder dot eval. Eval is a function. So inside that function we'll take container comma. Now we need to pass the string expression. So that's the string. So we need to take double quotes here. Data item dot resume. Here we need to pass the column name, that is resume. Okay. So after that, let's give comma. Now we need to pass here the format of the string. So that's need to give dot dot. Sorry, we should be in string. So that's why we need to take in within the double quotes. Dot dot forward slash then curly bracket open and close. Inside that we need to take zero. Okay. I think something went wrong here. Let me check. Let's stop the project. So okay, let's run and see. Close this one. Let's log in as an admin. We resume. Okay, now you can see the download link is now here available. When we hover on this download, you can see the bottom left, you can see link is generated. Okay, if you click on this, okay, let's click on this. So the doc file of the resume has been downloaded here. Okay, so that means we can download, the admin can download the resume of the user. Okay, if it is docs file, it will get downloaded automatically by clicking on the download. Okay, if it is PDF, then I think we need to take this one also. It's a doc file. Again, this one also is doc file, and this one also. Okay, all the resume is in doc file. Okay, and suppose if any of this resume is in PDF format, then as we click on the download, it will open that PDF file in a new tab. Okay, from there you can download that PDF file. For now, here can download the resume. Okay, and we can delete the applied jobs. Okay, so let's check that by deleting one record from here. Let's say let's delete the last one. So resume has been deleted successfully. Here can see, and the this one, the list of data is also get reduced from 4 to 3. Now the admin want to know for which job the user has applied. Admin got the details of the user, like from here, like their name, email and contact number, as well as they will going to get the details from the resume also, but they don't know like for which job they have applied, like the post, the company name, they can be same, okay, and the job title also they can be same sometimes. So they clearly don't know for which job they have applied. So that's why if we click on this row, okay, so it will take us to the job list page, okay, and it will going to highlight for which job this user has applied the job. Okay, so let's make some changes to our this existing page, view resume page. Okay, and so let's see, let's close this. Okay, it's showing here error, but it works in the browser. Okay, so there's no problem. Okay, we need to take two event for this grid view. Let's press enter here. On row data bound. So it will create event for us, the code behind page. Now let's take another event on selected index change event. Okay, it's supposed to create a new event here. Just save it and let's go to the code behind page here. Okay, can see the both event has been generated here. Now here we need to first let's pass here key dot row dot attributes within double quotes on click. Is equals to page dot client script dot get post back client hyperlink. So it's a function. So we need to pass here the ID of the grid view, that is grid view 1 in our case, comma. Now we need to pass the string argument. The first one that we need to pass, that is control. We have already passed the control ID, that is grid view 1. Now we need to pass the argument, like here we need to take string, okay, that is select dollar, okay. Then we'll concatenate here e dot row index semicolon. Okay, now let's give tooltip for this row. Okay, e dot row dot tooltip is equals to within the double quotes click to view job details. Save it. So we'll show you what it will going to do in browser. Okay, let's do this also. Let's take here for each loop. Review row let's take object row in our grid view. One dot rows. First it will check if row dot row index is double equal to grid view one dot selected index. If it is match, then it will come inside this if log. Now in design page we need to take one hidden field. So from that we are going to fetch the ID from the hidden field and we'll use it here inside this if condition. Okay, so let's take one hidden field in the design page of the v resume. So it can take anywhere. So I'm taking here inside this item template after the hyperlink. Okay, okay, let's break this. You have code from here, press enter. Yeah, now after this we'll take here one hidden field, this one, enter, double click on it. So it will going to add. Now we need to change the ID here. I am giving HDN, that is hidden. I am taking for the job ID, for which job this user has applied. So based on the job ID, we'll going to go to the job list page, okay, and we'll select that particular job ID. Okay, we'll select the particular job with the help of this job ID. So that's why we are taking here one hidden field which stores the job ID. Okay, now we'll take here one value property here, and inside that, okay, we'll take here single quotes, not double quote, open angular bracket, percentage, then hash. Need to take here one eval function, and inside that we'll pass our column name, that is job ID, which is going to come from our that page, like the function code behind page that taken the function. So applied job, right, that function will going to get data from there. Okay, and we'll make this hidden field as visible is equal to false. Okay, save it. Now we'll use this hidden field. This is ID. So let's copy here and we'll use inside this if log. Let's take here the class and let's give your object an object name here, job ID. Okay, now we need to convert into hidden field. So that's why we'll take here hidden field. Now here row dot, for which row we are going to get this hidden field. So it will go to find the control from that grid view with the help of the ID. So I just paste the ID here, semicolon. So it will going to get the data from the hidden field and will store inside this job ID object of the hidden field. Okay, now after that as we get the job ID, okay, now we need to redirect the admin to the job list page. Okay, so let's redirect them by taking response dot redirect. Job list.axps. Now we need to pass the job ID here with this job list page. Okay, so we're going to use a query string. So for that we need to add a question mark which denote it's a query string here we are taking. So the name of the like parameter I'm passing here, that is id. So we'll give a value to that id by taking plus. So here we'll take the object job id dot value. Okay, now what happens if didn't select any there that selected? Okay, at that time the else block row dot back color is equals to color. So we need to import the namespace for this class color. So just press control dot, the first one, that is system dot drawing, enter. So the namespace has added for that. Now we'll use here translate translator. Okay, that is not the color dot, it's color translator, this one. Okay, dot from HTML, and here we need to pass the color of that here in HTML format, that is hexa value I'm taking here, and that is I think white FF 6 time 3336. Okay, now after that we'll use the row tooltip, row dot tooltip. Click to select this row. So we will save it. Now let's run this project. Let's log in. View resume. Now when you hover over here, can see the tooltip has came. Click to view job details. Okay, so that is coming from here, this one. Click to view job details. Okay, now if we click on this first row anywhere, okay, so it will take us to this the page, but it said okay, styling that enable event validation is equal to true in configuration, or in page to pass event validation is equal to true. Okay, let's check it. Let's close this. Okay, let's go to a design page of view resume at the top. Here we'll take one enable event validation equals to false, save it. Now run this now run the project. We resume. Now click on the first one. Now it will take us to the job details page. Okay, but we didn't know like which job it was. It take us to that, but it didn't know which job is applied by the user. So here can see the job ID is there. So with the help of job ID, we'll make this that row selected for that job. Okay, so let's do that. And here in the resume, okay, While we are on the page of the job list details, we need to take here one button for the back button, back to the previous one. So when we click on that, it will take us to the view resume page again. Okay. So we'll take two things, like for one button here in the design, and one that the crew will going to highlight, like for which job the user has applied. Okay, so let's close the browser. Open the job list design page. Okay, let's open the first one, the code behind page for the job list. So we'll first add that the highlight part of that row. Okay. So here first we'll take one event, row data bound. So let's go to the design page, open this grid view. Let's take one event here on row data bound. Let's create event, save it. Now what the code behind page event has been generated here. Now we need to here write the code, if t dot row dot row type is double equal to data control row type dot data row. The row type is data row, then it will going to come inside this if condition. So here it will check e dot row dot id is equal to e dot row dot row index. Let's convert into two string semicolon. Now we'll check here within the if condition, if the request dot query string will give the query string very parameter here, like it's ID. Okay, the name of the query string is ID, and it will check like if it is not equal to null, then only it will execute this within the code within this if block. So we'll take here one integer with the job ID in which we are going to store the query string value. Okay, so for storing that not query string value here, we'll want to store, we're going to get the data from the grid view, from the grid view that this one can say data key names. So that we'll want to get from here, this one. So let's copy and paste it here. Advance, yeah, here, paste it. So here you need to take here e dot row. Now that has gone. Okay. So now we got the job ID. Now it will check if the job ID is double equal to same with the we are getting from the query string. Okay, so before that we need to convert that the value from the query string to integer format. So we'll convert it first, convert to in 32. Within that we use that query string. Okay, so that is request dot query string from here. Just copy and paste it here inside this to in 32. Okay, so after that, if it is matched, then e dot row dot back color. So we need to change the back color of the selected row in the grid view, right? So that's why we are taking here this one. So we'll use here color translator. So Okay, let's add your namespace for this color one. Control dot. So it is going to import the namespace system dot drawing. Now we can use color dot translator dot from HTML. Will give you the color hexavalue value code, that is hash. Now let's give the color code A1DCF2. This is the color code. I think it's in light blue. Okay, let's save it. Now let's run and see. Okay, let's take that back button in the design page. So let's open this job list design page. We'll do comment this label part here. Control KC. After that, okay, not that. We need to comment this whole div tag. Control KC. After that, we'll take here one div. Within the div, let's take class. BTN toolbar justify content between margin bottom 3. Okay, now inside this div we'll take another div, and in this div let's take class BTN group. Let's take here one label, that is here we have already taken. Let's copy this one and paste it here. Okay, now after that we need to take one hyperlink inside the div tag. So let's take here one class also inside the div. Input group h25. So inside this div tag we'll take hyperlink. If you want, you can change the ID of it. So I'll be using link pack. So we'll use your navigate property. Navigate URL is equals to which page we want to navigate back, like vresume.axps page. Click on this, so it will add code here for us. After that, let's give a class bootstrap class, that is btn hyphen secondary. Okay, let's make it visible. It should be false at starting. It should be visible when the admin come from view resume page to this job list page, then this button will go to this hyperlink will go to act visible. Or the otherwise it will go to hidden. Okay, let's remove this text, like from hyperlink we'll give here open angular bracket, then space back, okay, and save it. After this visible, let's enter. So it should be next slide. Okay, so this is a text part. Okay, this open angular bracket and back, so it will be the text which is been there in the hyperlink. Okay, it will display as a text. Just save it. Now let's run it. We resume. Now if we click on this, the first one, so it will take to the job details page. Now the job that is with the ID 1, that is the first one, is now been highlighted. The backlight has been changed to the light blue. Okay, so that means admin can know, like, for this job that user has applied. Okay, so if we click on the edit button, it will get the details of that this one. Okay, so like from the job list, we came here to a new job page. Okay, and we get here back button. Same way, we want to take here for this also, like if we going from the view resume page to this job list page. I have taken the design page, but didn't make it visible is called true in our the code behind page. So let's do that also. Let's close this one. I forgot to do that. Let's do it now. The code design page of the code behind page of the job list here. When here will take. So here it will check when the query string we have switching from that view resume page to this page, that is a job list page, with the help of query string, right? From that page we are redirecting to this page, redirect to this page with the help of query string, right? So we'll check here the first, the query string is there or not. That means request dot query string, the query string name, that is ID. If it is not equal to null, then we'll make that link button, link back dot visible is equal to true, otherwise it will remain false. Okay, semicolon, save it. Now run in browser, let's close this. Open login page, login as admin. We resume. Now click let's second one. Can see here this one, the second job is been highlighted, but I'm getting this back button to this left side. I want it to the right side. Okay, let's check the code. Job list design page here. Okay, we need to take this this code inside this div block. Just cut from there and paste it here. Okay, save it. Save it. Okay, now we refresh this page, button will go at the right side. Okay, now if we click on back, it will take us back to this view resume page. We click on this third one, it will take this third job which has been applied by the users. Okay, okay, in admin we have done this contact list. Okay, and resume also we have done, and this job list, new job also we have done. Now the remaining part, that is a dashboard part, will do that. And if you want, we can take one more page here, like it will display how many users are there, like it will going to display the list of user inside the grid view, okay? And the admin can manage also, like they can get, they are able to delete also, like which user they want to delete, they can delete it from there, okay? So we'll now take now only I think now I think only two videos will go to left, for one for this dashboard and one for that this one user, okay, where admin can manage the user. And here the logout functionality is remaining, okay? So that's it for today. So we'll meet in the next video. Till then, bye, take care, thank you for watching.